Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to be installing bus bars. We're upgrading the mobile power solar station with these bus bars. I don't know if you've seen that video yet, but it's basically the output of the buck converter was all blobbed together. I call it the blob, this big nasty connection. So we're going to break that out and place it nicely on these bus bars to distribute our power from our buck converter. So the input of this will be a max of 40 amps. This is not your typical bus bar you would use for a battery. This is much smaller. Let's take a closer look. Okay, so the kit comes with mounting screws, ring terminals for M4 and M6 connections, and the two bus bars. Comes with a cover. So you'll notice there's two larger posts. These are your M6 connectors. This is your input or output from your source or battery. And then there's eight smaller M4 connectors, and these are for your loads. And this can take up to a 12 gauge wire. And these are typically used in boat or automotive applications. All right, so we're looking at the back of the power station, and here's the blob connection. It's basically all the negative connections blobbed together. If you want to see a link to the current schematic of how this is currently wired, I'll put that right here, or in the description. So the negative bus bar we're going to do first because it has the most number of connections and it's the biggest problem currently. And we're going to install our bus bar right about here.
We'll start by drawing a line to make sure the bus bar is level. Next, we'll use the mounting screws to mount the bus bar.
Okay, that's it.
First, we will cut the main negative coming from the buck converter and land it on one of the M6 studs. Next, we can reconnect the other side going to the fuse box to the M6 stud as well. Now, we can strip the ends of both wires.
This is our ground going to our fuse block, which supplies all our DC electronics above, and that'll land here. And this is our ground for the relays, and that'll also land here. And then all these connections for the blob, we'll land them in our load connections here.
Next, we can add a ring terminal connector to the end of the wire. Next, we will add a bit of solder to the connector to secure the wire. This is optional. Now, we can add a lock washer and nut to the M6 stud. Finally, tighten with a socket wrench. Now, we can place our finished connections for the fuse box and relays on the other M6 stud. Finally, we can place a lock washer and nut on the M6 stud and secure it with a socket wrench.
So first we're going to have to disconnect that. So it looks like the one for the relay is going to be just long enough, hopefully. This one definitely not going to work for the switch. And this one also for the switch will work. So we're going to first do this one, make that wire longer. Well, when I was trying to take this off, the connector actually pulled right out of the switch. So now I'm going to have to order a new switch. Look at that. Unbelievable.
Now we can crimp, solder, and heat shrink our connection for the relays. See if you can catch the error here. I will realize it later on.
Okay, so all we have left is the little LED. This is our tiny, I think this is like 18 gauge wire, very small. We're going to have to connect that over here somewhere.
Now we can crimp, solder, and heat shrink the connection for the power led ground.
Okay, all our connections are made up. Now we can land them on our bus bar.
First, we will land the ground for the LED located inside the 20 amp switch. Next, we can secure the ground for the power led to the bus bar. And last, we can secure the ground connection for the relays.
Okay, all our connections are made. Okay, now we're looking at the front side of the power station. These are the two switches I was talking about earlier. Supply power to the fuse box, which supplies power to the USB outlets. So if everything's working right, I can press this pre-charge button and the power indicator should light up there. Okay, Now we can flip our breaker and turn on our DC switch. Check it out, it's charging. How cool is that? Charging my phone. So all our connections are good. That is awesome. So now we have a nice clean negative bus bar, and all we have to do is the positive bus bar.
We will start by mounting the positive bus bar. Next, we will cut the main supply line from the buck converter. Now, we can cut the line feeding the 20 amp relay circuit, which supplies power to the fuse block. The main supply line will land on the right side M6 stud. Now, we have to deal with the power led positive wire. It's too long, so we can cut it here. Next, we can strip the main supply wire and crimp on a ring terminal, add some solder, and finally, heat shrink it. Next, we will repeat the process for the supply to the 20 amp relay circuit. And now our supply connections are done.
So our power in, and then our supply out. There we go. I like it.
Next, we can prepare the connection for the positive side of the power LED.
Put our ring terminal connector. Just for good measure. That's it, all our positive connections are done. We got our power LED right here, which we'll get the whole bus bar. We'll put it right here. And it's kind of spoiled, yeah. And we'll put our LED and our switch connections for the relay coils right there. All right, so yeah, that's all the cleanup I really wanted to do. I just wanted to really deal with this, all the grounds. So yeah, I don't think I can really optimize it anymore. I mean, sure, I could take these loop-de-loops and connect them down individually, but that's kind of just, it's kind of splitting hairs. I just don't think there's any much point to that. But hey, it looks kind of cool. Okay, let's turn it around and fire it up and see if everything works. First, we'll pre-charge it. Okay, our light's on. Flip the breaker. So now we got power. Turn on our DC side. Cool, it's charging. Phone's charging. Very good, and let's see if this switch works. Very nice. Okay, so I'm gonna update the circuit on my website in case you're interested. It'll reflect the new wiring diagram with the bus bars. So yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching.